There are loads of different groups across Birmingham, providing spaces for parents to meet each other, get advice and information from professionals, and introduce their babies to each other. Some are structured sessions, where you can learn about a particular topic. Others are more informal opportunities, for a cuppa and a chat.
Friendships that come from it, obviously a lot of people meet up, and when you're off, particularly if you've been working full-time previously, being on maternity leave can be a bit of a shock. So having, you know, a ready-made community of women who can you know, support you with other things, with kids of the same ages and stages, I think is really helpful.
This postnatal support group, run by the NHS, runs on a six-week cycle where mums are invited to sessions where professionals give a presentation on a relevant topic. Paul came in to talk about road safety.
So if you do put your baby in the front of the car, please don't put one of these visors up, and also do not put this up if you cannot see the wing mirror.
We have the nappy lady, rhythm time, car and road safety, weaning, childhood illnesses, resuscitation, lots of different things. We do a lot of signposting to stay in place and different things like that, so they know where to. Once their 6 weeks is up, they've got other places to go to, and they sort of form friendships as well, which there's some mums that have been friends for like 18 years, and that they actually met at a postnatal support group and are still friends like 18 years on.
Some people probably think, you know, just as I did before I came, I thought maybe it's going to be, you know, not my kind of people, and I'm going to feel a bit out of it, and maybe it's going to be a lot of mothers who sort of are more, I don't know, have more experience than me, and are they going to watch and how I change him and feed him and stuff. But, you know, it's not, and I think everybody's in the same boat, so, you know, nobody's judging anybody else, and, you know, I'd just say give it a go, and you probably find that it's you really enjoy it.
Other sessions are more informal, like this drop-in baby cafe.
I think for some mums, this might be the only opportunity they have during the week, or maybe one of two opportunities to get out of the house, to meet other mums, to meet other adults, and have conversation about what it's like to breastfeed, what it's like to be a mum, some of the worries that they have, some of the positive things that they're experiencing.
I always sit on Wednesdays, so I don't even have got things on. I always make sure and say, you know, can't do Wednesdays because, you know, get the baby cafe, so no, it's really good.
When I arrived, I just started breastfeeding, and it was a little bit difficult, and one of the health visitors here just sat down with me and was able to watch what I was doing and help reposition me. And I think I'd watched a lot of videos and I'd read a lot of kind of literature, but actually having someone sat there with you, encouraging you and making sure that your baby was positioned right and you were positioned right and it was comfortable, and you could discuss how it felt and they could respond to that, was very, very helpful, I think.
One of the main comments that mums have said about coming to Baby Cafe is how welcoming it is, and how they've felt quite scared and anxious about coming out for the first time, and have been really impressed about the mums that have actually welcomed them in and have made them feel sort of part of a group as well.
Yeah, we've established a Facebook group, and
we tend to meet up during the week as well, because, you know, this is a limited period of time really, so, you know, on Wednesday.
Come along and be supported while you have a child who's completely dependent on you. If you're looking after another human being at that level of intensity, you need the support, and you need a place to come and share your concerns, share the experience with other mums.
Breastfeeding is the healthiest start you can give to your child, but as with other aspects of parenting, it is a skill to be taught and practised. Sessions take place around Birmingham to give mothers a safe space to get practical advice and gain confidence in feeding their child.
Breastfeeding is a normal, natural way to feed a baby. There's no no huge secret about it. It's your body produces the milk for your baby's growing needs, and it's individual to your baby. So as the baby grows, your body will produce milk to meet that baby's needs. There's many, many health benefits for breastfeeding.
I just think that it's really important to get some support with breastfeeding. If you don't get support in the first few weeks, you can be really put off very easily. And there's just a community of people who've got very real experiences with those sorts of things.
Health visitors, whenever they see the mums, they'll talk about breastfeeding if they're breastfeeding their babies, and go through the care that they need. That can be at home or in a clinic environment.
Yeah, well, I mean, I wasn't, at the start, I wasn't that keen, not that I wasn't that keen, but I had some reservations about breastfeeding, so I sort of went in with an open mind, and she took to it really well, and so it actually made it very difficult for me not to breastfeed.
We also have support groups in the community that we'll inform mums about, that they can access, and they can go to any of the groups. Some of them are based in children's centres, so in the children's centre they'll be able to access other staff that work there, and some other services such as baby massage or some of the relaxation stimulation rooms for babies. In their own time, whilst playing with the baby with all the toys that are out, they can start to open up to the members of staff that are there about any problems they might be experiencing, or if they haven't got any problems, just have a nice chat with some other mums going through the same thing of breastfeeding. If there is a problem and they want to talk about it in private, we'll always arrange them to be able to go into another room to sit down and have a one-to-one.
Almost everybody who has arrived has come in some sort of crisis. It could be something as simple as one breast doesn't seem to be working as well as the other, which seems strange but is really quite normal and a very common experience. And then after discussing what's normal and what they need to be concerned about, they leave feeling relieved and encouraged, and they continue breastfeeding.
There's a lot of encouragement. It's not that, you know, anyone says you've got to do this or you've got to do that, but you are encouraged to do it. It's free. It's cheap. It's a free option. And I really like doing it. It's really nice. It's a really bonding experience with her. She really likes it. And it's just really convenient.
Developmental checks take place at 1 year and 2.5 years to monitor the health and development of your child. It is an opportunity to discuss concerns and for health practitioners to provide advice and support if your child is not reaching the milestones for their age.
It's Daisy's 1 year checkup, developmental checkup. So they're just weighing her and measuring her and just checking that she'd reach certain milestones. And she seems to be good, so that's good news for Daisy. They were checking on how she's doing with her walking, crawling. She's trying to walk at the moment, as you can see. How she's getting on with her eating, whether she's got sort of hand-eye coordination, can pick things up.
Where's Charlotte?
Key areas of assessment include moving and doing, fingers and hand movements, social skills, as well as speech and language. For each check, you'll be sent a card which you can use to observe and assess your child prior to their review.
With the two and a half year check, we send out the assessment card through the post, and we ask parents to observe the child and assess them by ticking the card, yes, that they do it with ease, yes, just about, or no.
Feed self. Yes.
So no concerns with her moving? No. Fine. She gets up and down the stairs okay? Super. Oh, you're so good, aren't you?
Yes.
You're looking up at Daddy.
Well done.
Where appropriate, your health visitor may ask to see your child again, or they may make a referral onto other services.
We've got a whole variety of agencies that we can refer to, that we link into, and depending on what that problem is, it might be that we decide that it's correct to signpost that child to the children's centre, and maybe that family need the help and support that a children's centre can provide. It may be that child has got developmental delay, and therefore it'd be somewhere like the Child Development Centre that we would be referring that child to. It could be a speech and language problem, and therefore we refer them to the speech and language therapist. So depending on what problem we identify at any point of contact, we can then refer them to the appropriate agency. And again, that's a fundamental part of what health visitors do. We're very much a referring agency, that we can identify the problems and we can refer early and appropriately.
The Health Visitor Service aims to help you get the right help and advice at the right time. These wide range of services aim to provide a flexible programme which can support your child and your family as they develop and grow. Initial home visits and baby clinics aim to monitor your child and provide advice and support within the first year. Developmental checks monitor progress before your child reaches school age. The immunisation programme will prevent major childhood illnesses. In addition, postnatal support groups and breastfeeding clinics provide support to parents as well.